In this video, I'm going to be showing you RIU Palace over the course of 2 weeks, one of the largest five-star hotels on the island. I'll be showing you the food, the cleanliness, the activities, everything you need to know about this hotel will be covered in this video. To be honest, this is kind of the video I wish I had before I came here. We so nearly cancelled this holiday because we saw the review that went viral. Now, if you also saw the review that went viral, I strongly suggest that you watch this video till the end to determine if it's worth you coming to RIU Palace Santa Maria. Stay tuned, and without further ado, let's get into the video. Don't let RIU Palace fool you from the outside, because I kid you not, this place is like a TARDIS. When we came here, my first thought, and then I walked through the front doors, and oh my gosh, this place is massive. It even has its own water park. So reception is there, and then you've got these kind of like bar lounge areas where you can have coffee or cocktail. They organize and take your luggage up to your room for you, which is completely free. Is this our baggage?
All of our baggage right here. He's coming back with some more.
Go on, Ryan, use those muscles.
Easy.
Amazing. I don't know where he's gone. My bags always last for some reason. Look at that, my bag's upgraded itself. It can now knock. Okay, I'm gonna get changed into something cooler because it's very warm, and then we are gonna hit the bar.
Hit the bar.
Hit the bar. Oh yeah. You're not hitting the bar. You're underage. We're now just exploring the rest of the hotel, and it looks like there is a very long road ahead of us. I think we might have to get a buggy or something, guys.
Either that or we're gonna lose a ton of weight. There's a party on Friday.
Is there a party?
Yeah, either a white party or a neon party, one of the two.
I think I've got like a neon dress or something.
We'll be there.
We will be there.
We'll be there.
100%. Sun is going down. What are you clicking at? Oh my gosh, there's dogs! Hi! I had no clue that they had wild dogs here. They seem really friendly, but I just had no clue that they actually had them. That's incredible. We'll have to bring them some food tomorrow.
Yeah.
Right, we are now off to dinner after a long day of traveling. We're gonna go and eat until we explode. Entry into the buffet. It is absolutely massive. I'm really interested to see what the buffet is like, because I've heard or seen mixed reviews about this place. Wow. You got your fruit, even got a chocolate fountain. I'm having a big sleepover.
Turn the camera around.
What, to me?
Yeah.
Self-care is self-love, guys, okay?
Beautiful!
It is beautiful, right?
If you're trying to get tanned, you don't...
Look, this is me trying to get tanned, okay? Caring for my skin so that I can endure the amount of sun that you two can, so I can keep up with you both.
She can try, can't she, right?
Yeah. The time I get to your colour, I will look like I've aged by 20 years. So, I can't win, anyway. End of night one. Say bye, everyone.
Bye!
Ciao!
Ciao, ciao! Have you fun then, Nin?
Loving it. Nothing beats this. Apart from pina colada, obviously, whilst I'm here.
Is that my hint to go and get you a pina colada?
Ah,
oh,
you're gonna go get a pina colada?
Really?
Toil, I am.
Yeah, no doubt. Faster than that. Come on, Dory. Come and get your well-deserved drink. Ugh. You absolute princess.
Cocktail! Thank you!
You're it? Oh. Darling, don't worry. We're gonna refresh Janet. Let's go, Janet.
Right.
Feel like I'm
Look at this. Cleaning everywhere. They are always doing some kind of cleaning, or mopping, or sweeping, or gardening. There's always something going on to just keep this place under wraps. Now for some lunch, because I am absolutely starving. Two restaurants you can eat at, in fact there's technically three during lunch. You've got this one, you've also got the snack bar down at the bar near the beach, and then you've also got the lunchtime restaurant, but this is the bigger restaurant. There's three places you can eat, so you're never going to really be bored. Thank you very much. The boobs came in handy for something. Janine, can you see yourself?
Yeah.
Can you see the food?
Yeah.
Bearing in mind this is lunchtime, we've got seafood. So this is my bit of food here. We've got an array of stuff. Hey! You wanna play? Really see from a distance how big that hotel is. That doesn't even get to it, that's where it starts, where the water park is.
Yeah.
And then all across and around there. Look very pretty, Janine.
Why, thank you. It's the sunlight.
It is, it golden helps. Hour. Sao as a whole is actually quite rocky. There's not a lot of tropical vibe here. However, with this place, there is greenery everywhere. There's different colours, there's different plants, there's sand, there's palm trees, there's these pink flowers, pink reddish flowers. Pose for us, Nene. This is Janine's photo shoot. As you can see, she's doing very well. Anyone out there that's got any modelling deals for Janine, we'd be super grateful. Yep, I think that's the vibe she's going for. Beyonce on a beach vibe.
I've taken about 30 pictures.
Beautiful.
Is that the Lion Mountain over there?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Kind of just looks like a face popping out.
I think at a certain angle that they take us to, it looks like a sleeping lion.
Ah, okay, fine. Lion sleeps tonight. You guys were supposed to join me on the wee bit.
Lion's voice goes that high and mine don't.
When I used to watch David Attenborough, I heard monkeys with lower voices than that. What on earth is that? I mean, it's making me look like I've got some supreme highlighter on, but it's not even contour because it's pink. So I refuse to go to dinner tonight because of the obvious. I just can't. Anyway, good night. As you can see, I'm fully covered up for today. Thanks to that little mishap yesterday. Just gonna go and get some breakfast now because today we are exploring the island. I haven't shown you the breakfast yet, but we've got the typical English breakfast. We've got donuts, cakes, we've got eggs, I like toasties and tortillas. Have some fresh fruit, which I'm going to grab this morning.
Come here, this way.
We were just walking through the hotel and we came across this board, which is basically a timetable of all the activities they've got on. They've got stretching, they've got abs, they've got yoga, they've got aquafit, they've got so many different things that you can do just for exercise. And then they've also, what other stuff have they got?
Wow.
All this stuff here, bowls, everything. They've even got an art
yeah. It tells you what's on the stage, fun.
Yeah. This place is incredible. Karaoke. Oh my gosh, I've got karaoke too.
This is
what's on today.
Today
we've got everything. Oh my gosh, look, they've got dance lessons.
Yeah, live piano earlier. We've got live music now till 10.
What's that?
That's studio. Tomorrow.
What's Studio 54 though? Where is that? Teatro Simboa.
That's the main stage. We've got live music. and then at 10:30, karaoke tonight.
I could live here. I could live at this hotel. I really could. I absolutely love it. Let's just try and not focus on the sand. I look like I've been skiing on one cheek. I'm gonna do a karaoke. Oh my god, this is scary.
Yeah, she's on her own.
Last night is the first night that I got properly drunk, because last night was a massive win. We got back from exploring the island and I had some really, 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 really good news. I feel awful today. And I would obviously decide to get drunk when I'm going to the gym the next morning. Why do I do this? Okay, anyway, enough of that complaining. I don't know if you can see, but I've got cream all over my face as well, because I woke up and I was like, oh, my skin feels dry and burnt and pink. So I'm gonna lather moisturizer on and just let it set. And I don't know if you can see it, because I can't see a thing, because it's so sunny and bright. I guess the real question at the moment is RIU Palace really the death trap it's been made out to be? Well, the honest truth is, I don't know yet, but that's why we're here and that's what we're gonna find out. I haven't died yet, so that's a good sign. We're hiding from my brother.
Janine!
It's like a sound monster. Are you doing that? Oh, he's there!
Hide!
He's not trying to hide. He's trying to hide. Okay, fine, I'm gonna turn the camera around. Hold on. Stay there, Janine. Who's coming?
See you later.
Bye.
Yes. 5 days in, what's been your favourite part so far?
Hiding from Ryan, getting drunk.
Cheers for that.
Adult pool. Yeah.
I told you, it'd be good to spend some time here.
Dude, I was like,
Yeah.
Oh, it's been amazing.
How are you going
to
make
to warm up. Exactly. That's like scientifically. There's even a whole dog dedicated to it.
No, oh, Burmese mountain dog.
They send them
up pools, don't they? They're fast, obviously.
You do indeed.
Where's my Burmese mountain dog?
I'm here.
Oh, no.
That wasn't supposed to happen. Prosecco with some chlorine, anyone?
Good old Janine, she's gone back to the bar to get everyone.
Oh, what have you got? Let's see. You look like a giant from here, like a dark giant. Let me see what you got. What have you got for the snack bar?
Cussed out because they said 4 beers morning, and I was like, it's 12 o'clock somewhere else, right?
Oh my god. Stay there now, Shannon. Run now, otherwise the next one's gonna come.
No, not doing it.
So we have been recording for 2 minutes and 15 seconds and Shannon still hasn't managed to enter the sea.
It's because the waves are like, they have no clue what they're doing. where our friends are, Nina. I reckon they're over that ridge trying to find the doggies at the moment to give them some water.
Some agua. Look, there's a doggy footprint.
We're tracking. I have to walk sideways on so that I don't get burnt by this beast. Yes, not because I genuinely want to walk like a crab. Wow. What are you grabbing?
No.
You look like you're pulling an invisible rope.
They open and close their claws.
What, whilst they walk like that? You look like you're doing some kind of traditional dance from your native town. Wherever that may be. Look at this sea. We're about to give Janine a photo shoot. She's waiting for me. I'm coming, Janine. Okay.
Photo shoot.
Another thing I love about this place is that it has its own shop, has alcohol, anything gift-wise you want to take home, it's pretty much got. I think it's safe to say I'm pretty much in love with this hotel. By far, this is the grandest hotel that I've ever been to. It's got 4 restaurants outside of the buffet. It's got 6 pools, which include 1 spa pool, 2 adult pools with swim-up bars. It's a beachfront location. Everything's included. It has its own parties on Fridays, as well as a Pasha disco. There's so many places to eat. There's so many activities you can do. I'm blown away by the just sheer size of this place and everything it has to offer.
Tonight's a good night because we're gonna try and find the Pasha Disco, and my sunburn is getting there, so it's acceptable for me to go out and actually socialize at this point in time. So yeah, we're gonna try and find the Pasha Disco tonight.
We're on our way to the neon party. But just be warned that the neon party is in the sister hotel, which is in the Funana hotel. So it's a bit of a walk. The Funana hotel seems really nice as well. Fantastic quality. You do have 5 restaurants to choose from, one of which is the main buffet restaurant that you have at dinner. If you want to kind of veer away from the buffet restaurant, then what I would suggest you do is you look at the 4 restaurants that RIU Palace has to offer. So one of the 4 restaurants, which is my favorite, is Dorayaki. Dorayaki is a sushi and Japanese cuisine. It is like a 5-star restaurant. Everything is served to you. It's a real restaurant experience, and the decor, the atmosphere, the customer service is what you'd expect from a 5-star restaurant, and I absolutely loved it.
When you come to Dorayaki, they give you like a QR code, you scan it, it gives you a menu, and then you pick your starter, main, and dessert, and then they bring that out to you. So far, so good. I like the atmosphere in here. Well, I've just had the appetizer, and I kid you not, I could have had 10. They were so, so tasty.
Aren't they amazing?
Absolutely delicious. By far, this is our favourite restaurant, would you say? Best meal that I've had. Best meal I've had here so far, like, incredible. I look forward to what the rest looks like. Starter, I have, oh my gosh, I've just put my whole wrist in it. We have an assortment of sushi, which is everywhere.
But the main is like some chicken-y kind of pastry thing. It's very nice. The next restaurant you have is an Italian themed restaurant, which is called La Paradella. The food is gorgeous. I absolutely loved it. Again, so much variety. Where this differs from Dorayaki is that the starters and also the dessert is buffet style. Then the main course within the Italian restaurant, there's actually a kitchen area that you can see them cook it on. It is cooked in the restaurant and that is served to you, but the starters and the desserts, you do have to go up and get yourself.
Do you get the seafood spaghetti?
Nice.
Samurai.
Lasagna.
Lasagna, mushrooms and spinach.
Wow.
Very good.
The other one we went to is the steakhouse, which, if I'm honest, it's okay. Thing is, the restaurant that it's in is actually the restaurant that you go to at lunch. So it's the same kind of thing. Yes, they dress it up and make it a bit fancy with cool lighting and everything, but I would personally prefer a more themed restaurant, I guess, when you think of a steakhouse. I tried the burger, which was absolutely delicious, and the food is lovely, but I don't know, I guess seeing all the other restaurants being themed, I was expecting this one to be themed too. There is also vegetarian options as well that you can choose from, so great if you're vegetarian. The only thing I'll have to say about these restaurants is that you have to book incredibly quickly. Their bookings are done via the RIU app, so I'd suggest that upon arrival to RIU Palace, you download it straight away so that you can book any restaurants, because the slots do fill up super fast. So the best way that you're going to get a slot in these restaurants is if you wake up early and book. All the restaurants cater for all dietary requirements and there is something for everyone. Now let's get onto the facilities of RIU Palace, because I kid you not, this place won't disappoint. Here you'll find 5-star facilities such as the spa and gym, which are all included. Treatments are at a cost, but you can use these facilities, the sauna, the actual spa, the indoor pool, without having to pay for anything. You just have to book ahead, and how you do that is you head down to the spa and gym reception and they will get you booked in. You have 6 pools. You have 1 indoor one and 5 outdoor pools, 2 of which are adult only pools with swim up bars. Wi-Fi is accessible anywhere and everywhere throughout the hotel, and even when I'm on the beach I can get Wi-Fi, so the Wi-Fi is super strong, it's super fast. In terms of the cleanliness here at the hotel, it hasn't faltered. Since being here I've seen consistent cleaning, disinfecting, clearing, wiping, watering, you name it. I see people clearing tables, wiping tables, disinfecting things, clearing away glasses, constantly. There hasn't been one moment where I'm like, oh, that's a bit iffy. But there's not one thing I can comment on negatively about the cleanliness of this place. Now let's talk about the staff. The staff here are so friendly. Everyone says hola, everyone says thank you. I'm really, really enjoying it here so far. Couldn't complain about the service that I've received from the staff members at all. So far, I'm super impressed with this place. I think it's beautiful. I love the staff. I love the vibe. The real question at this point in time is RIU Palace really the death trap it's been made out to be? And to answer that question, yes. RIU Palace is the death trap. I'm joking. We had the best time here. Unfortunately, my camera and the footage that I had, it has disappeared. And I know these things happen, so there we are. Not one of us got sick, not one of us had a bad experience, and I get that bad experiences are inevitable wherever you go, and no one I knew had food poisoning whilst we were there. So much fun. And if you found value in this video, then I'd really appreciate a subscribe and a like, and give us a little comment if you enjoyed it, or what you'd like to see next time. Thank you for watching. Bye.